My favorite film is Closer.
Pulp Fiction. Probably Shawshank Redemption.
Get busy living. You get busy dying.
Just thought of Doctor Strange Love.
Moments. Back to the Future.
Roads. Where we're going, we don't need roads.
It's gonna play the rain.
Where's Peter's day off?
They're in the way.
You talking to me?
Zucro.
Jim Carrey.
Natalie Portman.
Tom Hardy will be my favorite actor.
Don't be afraid to dream a little bigger, darling.
I'd have to say Judd Apatow.
Martin Scorsese.
Quentin Tarantino.
I think we all think the bag was a nice idea.
Yeah.
But not pointing any fingers. They could have been done better.
John Carpenter?
Probably Ryan Coogler who made the new Black Panther film.
Because making something disappear isn't enough. You have to bring it back.
I guess just from a young age, like I was always watching films anyway. From that exposure, film is just like a way to communicate, see other people's stories and stuff, you know? It's kind of become something important like that to me.
They transport you to a different world.
Some movies can tell you a lesson. They have life morals in it, so I like that.
My mom always said, life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get.
Pardon my French, but if you suck a piece of coal up his ass and wait 2 weeks, it will come out a diamond.
Pardon my French, but Cameron is so tight that if you stuck a lump of coal up his ass, in 2 weeks, you'd have a diamond.
In Pulp Fiction, when he's turning around to talk to the guy and he has a gun and accidentally shoots him.
Oh man, I shot Marvin in the face.
Why the fuck did you do that?
Well, I didn't mean to do it, it was an accident.
In the Green Mile, when they're about to kill your man John Coffey in the electric chair, and he goes, "Don't put me in the dark again, boss. I'm afraid of the dark." It's, you know, it's kind of like sad, but it's also sort of, I don't know, a good quote, something that you remember. Like.
Harry Potter, the Order of the Phoenix, when they're all in the exam hall, and then the Weasley twins set fireworks off, and then they all run out. I think it's a really, really good scene.
Feckin' invested. When I was a kid, I wanted to be Spider-Man.
Fly!
I really am more of a person who looks into the character and the story side of it. I'm more for the acting than I would be for the camera shots and all that stuff. Even though it is interesting and nice to look at, I prefer the characters and the story.
One shot.
I get really invested, and I can get really annoyed as well by endings of movies. It's like it doesn't go the way that I wanted it to.
In the visual sense, like I just find it easier to connect with characters and stories that way, while with a book, I guess, I don't know, I just don't read into the actual like contents of the story and stuff.
That's weird. What the hell is Goofy?
If they don't introduce the characters and where it's set in the first like 10 minutes, it bothered me.
My name is Lester Burnham. This is my neighborhood.
Like what the tone of it is and like the beginning and then kind of writing with that and seeing how they where they take it.
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a gangster.
The soundtrack or kind of the display of like the settings.
I love 80s movies, but then I love all the cheesy comedies from the 90s.
I'll have what she's having.
For the 70s.
From probably the 70s to the 90s.
80s or 90s, kind of like Back to the Future. everyone watches films for different reasons. Like, someone might be like well into books and like properly reading and analyzing books, but like they might just watch action films, you know, they might not be big into it.
Some people be total opposite of the film so much.
Like, if you're like me, you go from watching a gory action film to The Notebook.
Was it over? Still isn't over.
You don't see a person who loves rom-coms going around thinking his life is a rom-com.
No, John Hughes did not direct my life.
Yeah, for sure. I think one that comes to mind is 12 Angry Men. It's a really like empathetic story about like not judging people at face value and stuff. I mean, you know, a really broad lesson, but I guess one that we kind of forget sometimes. And I don't know, I left that just thinking about people in my own life differently, like taking the time to imagine what's going on in their head, like behind the scenes and stuff.
Films that are dramatic or kind of inspirational aim to be that way.
Some films, let's say Interstellar, like my favourite one, they have very deep meaning and perspective on life. Let's say space, it's just the way Christopher Nolan just portrays space and like things the world would work.
I think Disney movies and stuff taught you like, if you do good things, then good things will happen to you.
He left an opening for a new partner. Congratulations.
I think a lot of films anyway that could deal with particularly like people going through troubles in their life, whatever, I can really, I don't know, it's easy to kind of empathize with them, just kind of go, ah, that's how people feel.
Oh, God, yeah.
Yeah.
My laptop doesn't even have a DVD player.
We're in an age where you can just tap on the download button and you have it, or even just go on like pirated site and just watch it for free.
Yeah, I said it there, even though I do closely collect on the Blu-ray. Sad to see that no one is going in and buying them, because it was before when I was younger, going into X-Vision and stuff, I used to enjoy, love to go into X-Vision and going in and just looking at the DVDs.